Oh, it's a cat. Oh, it's a kitty cat. What's up? Shmeow. Oh, that's not a kitty cat. Oh, it's a big rat. A forest rat wolf. Oh, yeah, that ain't no kitty cat. Hello, and welcome to the Nerd Out Shelter, where it's a safe place to nerd out. And today, I am playing Loop Hero. Now, this is an RPG where we wield an expanding deck of mystical cards that includes enemies, buildings, and terrain, and we place them along a randomly generated loop. It sounds pretty cool. It's the first time I've ever played, so let's start. Oh, it looks like we can pick the hero color, so we're definitely going with Nerd Out Shelter Yellow. Haha, nice. The stars in the sky are going out, one by one. But no one notices it. No one can stop it. I'm racing to the last place, where there is still hope. I need to make it before it's too late. The sounds of agony will quickly fade. The world will be destroyed, even the memory of it will be gone. And even if there is absolutely no chance of bringing it all back, there will always be someone who is willing to do the impossible. In a place without space, without time, without memories. Oh, okay. Oh, that's pretty ominous. Where am I? I can't see anything except this path. My head is killing me. I remember only a skeleton with a staff up in the sky. This darkness was coming from him. Did he destroy everything around here? Oh, we gotta rebuild the world with our cards. Okay, that's cool. Just standing here won't do me any good, I guess. Oh, okay, so we got planning mode. To change between adventure, traveling through the map, and planning, stop, modes, press Y. Continue your journey by changing the game mode. Okay, let's press Y. Oh, now we're on an adventure. Oh, cool, we're going around the loop. Hope I'll be able to find some shelter, a nerd out shelter, before nightfall. If night still even exists without the sky, that is. Yeah, I guess it's perpetual night now. Okay, still going around the loop. Oh. Pay attention to the day progress bar at the top of the screen. New enemies usually appear at the end of the day. Oh yeah, the freaks come out at night. Continue your journey by changing the game mode. To change between adventure... Oh yeah, I already know that. Okay, I'm gonna press Y, I guess. Oh yeah, there's a slime or something. A living ball of slime. Oh, let's hope he doesn't have ambition. Quite a nuisance. They digest anything they can. Well, hopefully not me. Hey, I remembered this creature. Maybe I just need to freshen up my memory and everything will go back to normal. Traveling, fighting, and most other actions are done automatically. The player can't affect them directly. Oh, okay. We're gonna press B to continue. All right, take out the slime, please. Whoa! Get some strikes in there, man. He's hitting back, but we got him. Nice. It's hard to fight with your bare hands. I think there's an undigested weapon in the remains of that thing. Ew. You have an inventory and an item slot. You know what to do. Okay, hold ZR to switch to the item selection and equip sword. Oh, okay, that's cool. All right, let's equip it. Oh, it's a gladius. All right, it does 4 to 6 damage. All right, I'm taking that. Put it there. Thank you. I think I remember there was a grove nearby. Are these even my memories? Or do they belong to that slime? You can use cards that are left after defeating enemies to add various new objects to the map. That's what planning mode is for. Hold ZL to switch to a card selection and place the card with left stick and A. Okay, we need to drag the card to a suitable space to remember the land. Whoa, okay. So ZL... Oh, okay, so, oh, we're putting it right there. All right, let's do it. Oh, cool, good. Now, continue your journey. All right, let's keep going. We're going on an adventure around the loop. I guess we're heading to the grove. Hopefully there aren't any more slimes that come out and jump in front of me. Uh-oh, oh, it's a cat. Oh, it's a kitty cat. What's up? Shmeow. Oh, that's not a kitty cat. Oh, it's a big rat. Oh, at least I got the sword, though. A forest rat wolf. Oh, yeah, that ain't no kitty cat. I was right. Some emotional stress, a few vivid images, and a bit of adrenaline, and I'll forget it all like a bad dream. I mean, I'll remember it all like a bad... Damn it! Good thing nobody heard that. As you probably already noticed, you can get new items and cards during battle. Some items have unique features, as do most of the cards. By holding ZR or ZL and choose item or card, you can inspect its properties. Equip a new weapon and place your new cards on the map to continue. Whoa, okay, we got a new sword over here. Whoa, the scimitar! Okay, it has +4 attack speed. All right, definitely want to do that. So place that there. All right, get rid of my old sword. Whoa, okay, now we have a forest and a rock. So let's pick the forest. And, oh, that's cool. Okay, I guess we're gonna put it right here in the middle. Nice. All right, now we're gonna pick the rock. Its magnificent appearance gives you strength. Whoa, +3 hit points, +3 more hit points for every adjacent rock or mountain. Oh, that's cool. I guess we're gonna put it right there. Good. So there's a mountain over there, and a forest over here. The world's almost back. The branches and stones in my backpack are a sure sign of that. Some of your actions will yield resources that you will need later on, but not right now. But that shouldn't stop you from looking at them right now. Okay, continue your journey by changing the game mode. Alright, let's keep going. Alright, we're heading on an adventure. Oh, we're going all the way around. We're probably going to hit back to the camp here. That's where we started. Oh, I heard a rooster. I think it's time to get some rest. Oh yeah, that sounds good. The game itself is a journey on a looped path. Only you will decide when it is time for the hero to return to the camp. Either you or the fangs and claws of your enemies, of course. Oh man. You can retreat almost any time. Oh, that's good. I'm going to do a lot of that. But a special animation will let you know when it's safer to do so. Alright, retreat to the camp by pressing X. Alright, let's head back to the camp. You consider returning to the cozy camp right now, while you're still alive and walking. Good thing the camp is right nearby. Now's the perfect chance. Okay, retreat and you keep all resources. Alright, yeah, let's get out of here. It's cold and dark here. A small fire can solve both of those problems. Nice place to set up camp. This is when all resources you've gathered will come in handy. Who would have thought? You have just enough wood and stone to make a campfire. What a nice coincidence. Oh yeah, it's almost as if somebody designed it. Build a campfire using the building function while in a camp. Press the build button, select the campfire, and place it. Alright, let's... Oh, okay, so now we got a campfire. The hero restores 20% of his max hit points upon entering the campfire tile. Oh, nice. Alright, it's a healing campfire. There we go. Congratulations! You've beaten this annoying tutorial! You can now start your first expedition. Or not. Do as you wish. Well, I wish to start my first expedition, so let's do it. Alright, expedition menu. Let's start. Oh, we got some trophy here. Okay, the new beginning. Nice. This path. Everything is wrong. But I remember. Oh, there's a lot of slimes. They look like they have a lot of ambition. It looks like a completely different place, and it's empty again. Do my actions have any meaning? Hey, I've been wondering that every day of my life. Like I have a choice. If I need to give up and cry to save the world, I am the worst savior of all. Let's do it. All right, yeah, let's do this. Let's keep going. Oh, I got a slime. All right, it's coming up. We're gonna fight him. All right, I got my scimitar, so it should be a quick work of this slime. Yeah, nice. Okay, got some good cards there. Oh, we got another rock. Okay, so let's place the rock. I'm gonna put that, I guess, not in the middle. Oh, because it gives me more strength, though. Oh, maybe I do. All right, yeah, we'll put a mountain that we walk around. That's kind of... Oh, we actually have a mountain. Okay, let's select that. Oh, there we go. All right, what does that do? It's like a rock, but really big. Yeah, that makes sense. All right, oh, so plus 5 for each adjacent rock or mountain. Oh, I should have placed it somewhere where I can put everything around it. Dang it. Okay, that was a bad placement for that rock. See, I should put it over here. That's fine. I'm gonna put it here because I like it. There we go. Oh, and a beacon. Okay, what does that do? A worthless landmark in a world of no direction. All right. Plus 40% movement speed with its range. 20% attack speed for all its units. That doesn't seem very worthless. All right, let's go ahead and place that. Can I put it here? No, I gotta put it next to the path. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's cool. All right, so I want to fight that slime. You know what? I'm gonna put it right there. There we go. All right, let's keep going on our adventure. We gotta head over to this slime over here and take him out. I'm coming for you, buddy. I don't have any beacon effects because that's not until I get up here. But I'm gonna take this one out. It should be easy. Just a little slime, right? What could possibly go wrong? Come on, get him! Hit him one more time. Nice. All right, what did we get? Oh, a new weapon. All right, let's check it out. Oh, it's a bad sword. Okay, no, I don't want that. All right, let's keep going. We got another slime up here. We'll have our beacon effect. So we should go a little bit faster. Oh, there we go. Yeah, nice. All right, and we have 20% attack speed. So we should hit him harder and faster. Come on, one more hit. Oh, nice. All right, got some more cards. Whoa, Vampire Mansion. Oh, hungry eyes follow your every move through the holes in the roof. Oh, that sounds spooky. Adds vampires to battles on the tiles around it. Okay, do I really want to do that? All right, well, I guess, yeah, we're going to fight the vampires next. Let's put it there. And we got another rock, so I'm going to put that over here to increase my boost here with the mountain. All right, let's keep going. We're going to walk past the Vampire Mansion. Oh, okay. I didn't see any vampires in the front yard, so we're taking on slime then. Come on. Get him. One more hit. So it takes 3 hits with my scimitar. Whoa, we got a spider cocoon. Let's check that out. A silky bastion of 8-legged hunters spawns a spider on the adjacent tile once a day. Oh, that's cool. All right, so let's place this in front of me. Hopefully, we'll get to fight him. Let's go right there. Oh, and we have a meadow. Earth covered with a thick carpet of grass. Nothing really interesting, unless you're a cow, of course. Heals 2 hit points at the start of each day. All right, well, let's go ahead and place that. So I guess I'm gonna put it near the spider nest. There we go. Whoa, okay, we got something from that. I don't know what that was, but I got it. All right, let's keep going. going on an adventure. Hopefully the spiders will come out. Yes, we got a spider. Oh, man, that's a big spider. Oh, we got him. Oh, new trophy, first blood. Oh, we went all Rambo on that spider. All right, let's keep going. We're going to take on this slime and hopefully get some new weapons or something inside of him. I'm going to take 3 hits with these slimes. Oh, okay, we got something there. Oh, treasury. Okay. Gives a random basic resource after placing anything on an empty tile around it. Must be surrounded by empty space when you build it. Whoa, okay. So I got to build it way out here and put things around it. So I'm going to make sure there's space to the left and right of it. So let's go right there. All right, we got ourselves a treasury. Let's keep going. There's another slime coming up. Let's get him. And yes, take him out. Come on. One more hit. Yes. All right, what'd we get? Oh, more rocks. Great. All right, we're going to place those, I guess, over here next to my mountain. Yeah, there we go. There we go. We're filled up in the middle there. Let's keep going. Looks like camp is the next stop. Let's head back to camp. All right, I got a bunch of resources that I'm going to keep, so let's go ahead and retreat. I can't believe it. Hey, everybody, the boy managed to return. Of course I did. Survivors? Does this mean that I'm not alone anymore? Where did you come from? Where did you go? Joe, is there still a place without darkness? We don't know where we came from, but it was a long time ago. That, or we can't remember. These few people are all that's left of our group, I think. You're not sure? We're not sure. We reached that conclusion based on the abandoned luggage and leftover daily rations. Oh, abandoned luggage. You must have been flying Continental Airlines. Each day, we see the signs of other people's presence around us. But as far as we know, they don't exist and never did. It's like we forgot them. Forgot them? Exactly. It's as if these people are disappearing every day and we instantly forget they existed. Just like we forgot where we came from. And our families. Maybe even ourselves. My name is Yoda. Y-O-T-A, Yoda. That I still remember. Yeah, every lyric. Everyone else's memories are not that much better. That's why I remember so little about myself. Everything is forgotten. But wait, you said I managed to return. That means you remember I was here. Yes, that's why it's so important to us. We saw you leave, but you were gone before we could approach you. Listen, we can't keep wandering in this emptiness anymore. There's a campfire here, and enough space for a few sleeping bags. A real luxury in these dark times. What do you say? Okay, yeah, we're gonna join a sleeping bag with Yoda over here. But that's gonna have to wait until next time, because that does it for this episode of Loop Hero! If you like this video, please leave a like. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss the next video. And until next time, thank you for visiting the Nerd Out Shelter, where it's a safe place to nerd out!